Hi, I'm Tracy Shields, a biomedical librarian at the NIH Library. In this section of searching the literature, we're going to go over other tools that you may use to help support your search. In this section, we're going to talk about some of the ideas for documenting your search process, but also some tools that could help support your information needs as part of your research, and how to keep up with new and emerging literature. Now, search documentation isn't a very exciting topic, that is for sure. But think of it as a way to be kind to your future self. Searching documentation can be done a lot of different ways. It can be very simple. It can be very complex. It could be something as simple as a Word document that you've copied and pasted your search strategies into to kind of keep track of what you've been doing. But there are also tools such as the PubMed search history that you can export as an Excel spreadsheet that will help you document what you've been doing. And the importance of documentation is that it allows you to remember what you did, or perhaps what you didn't do, the number of results that you got, and also in case you need to revisit your search, you don't have to rebuild everything from scratch. Something I would strongly suggest to you is consider adding notes or comments on your thought processes during your searching. And it could be something as justification for a decision you made of leaving in a term or leaving out a term, because oftentimes you may not remember why you did a certain thing. Having that as part of your search documentation can be an invaluable tool, especially as you move forward in your research process, even to the point where when you're publishing your article, if you have questions from peer reviewers, you may need to go back to those notes and explain why you did one thing versus another. Experiment with what works best for you. There are different ways to document your strategies, but also what you do now may not fit when you do research later. So be willing to try different things out to see what works. So setting up literature alerts is a great way to keep track of the literature, and there's a lot of different ways you can do that. Many databases and resources have features that may allow you to set up alerts yourself. This could be done through a personal account, such as PubMed's MyNCBI, or it could be done through the database itself. You can save searches, and that can help you set up alerts for anything new that may come up with your results. Or you can get alerts directly from journals and publishers. You may be familiar with what are called TOCs, or table of contents, which is when a new issue comes out of a particular journal, you get an alert either through an app or even by email of what's newly published from that journal. There are also specific apps that you may want to consider that help you with literature alerts. Some of these include the fee-based ones such as Stork, or there could be free ones such as PubCrawler or Google Alerts. And again, something else to consider is RSS feeds. This can be done with specific searches. It could be done through journals and publishers, or it could be a news site or even press releases that you see through RSS feeds. You may have apps specific to reading RSS feeds, or it could be done through something as simple as Outlook or other email programs. Then there's also social media or social networks that will be great at getting the most recent literature, whether it's published by a specific researcher, a university. Again, I mentioned the press releases, but a lot of the dissemination happens on social networking sites such as LinkedIn, Mastodon, ResearchGate, and Twitter. Something else to consider with your research is something called a reference management software. These are software or apps that help corral all of those papers and citations you come across. Some of them are fee-based, such as EndNote or ReadCube Papers or SciWheel, but some are also freely available, such as Mendeley and Zotero. You can even use Excel spreadsheets as a reference manager. And these will also oftentimes allow you to connect the citation to full text, PDFs, and be able to share with other people, and then also do things within Word or other Office products that will allow you to cite and insert citations as you write. They can be very powerful and provide a lot of support with your research and dissemination. Some other resources to consider include the Collaborative Institutional Training Initiative, or CITI program, which has a lot of training and webinars based on how to do research and even applying or taking part of an institutional review board, or IRB, as part of your study. Then there are NIH resources such as the NCATS Clinical Research Toolbox, which is linked here on the slide, online training courses such as the one that you're taking right now, and things such as Research Match, which will allow you to connect to your research subject in meaningful ways. So in summary, documenting the search is not really an exciting topic, but it's an important factor to consider. And there are many other tools that are out there to help you with your information curation, whether it's setting up literature alerts, keeping track of the literature, or using citation management software to keep track of everything you've come across. Some questions to consider. What search tools fit your research needs? And how do you keep track of your full text articles? Are there other tools that you could use? Thank you for listening.